Welcome to the YouTube channel Academic Mind. A second chance called tomorrow. Grade 9 English, Unit 5, Part 1. The first part of this video lesson is focusing your attention on talking about future events. Future tenses are used to represent actions which will happen in the future, the activities that we hope to do or the activities that we have already planned to do in the future can be expressed through future tenses. Now look at the example sentences given. I will give a speech in the program tomorrow. Robert will be going to the university next week. Tom will have reached the place by now. We will watch a movie this Friday. Patrick will have been cooking the meal before you reach home. Donna will prepare the dessert soon. Now in all these sentences, the future activities are expressed. But when you look at the sentences carefully, you can notice that different verb patterns can be seen there. Will give, will be going, will have reached, will watch, will have been cooking, will prepare. So these are the structure or the verb patterns that you can see in different future tenses. As we discussed earlier, different structures of future tense can be used to express different future events. The first one is predictions or statements of fact. Number two, actions in progress in the future. Number three, scheduled events or timetabled events. Number four, intentions. Number five, arrangements. If we are predicting something or forecasting something that can be happened in the future, we have to use the auxiliary verb will in simple future tense. So the formula for the simple future is will plus root form of verb. It doesn't matter if the subject is singular or plural, the formula for the simple future doesn't change. Now look at the three example sentences given in simple future tense. Lunch break today will be 10 minutes longer than usual. She will come tomorrow definitely. Ben will do the assignment as soon as possible. So here will be, will come, will do are the verb structure which belongs to simple future tense. The actions that will be continuing in a certain period in the future or the actions in the progress in the future will be expressed through future continuous tense. What is the formula of it? Will plus be plus ing verb. Now look at the example sentences given. We will be watching a movie next Friday. Will you be going to the concert? Robin will be joining us at the meeting. Now in these three sentences you can notice how the formula works. Will be watching, will be going, will be joining. So these activities are continuous actions which will happen in the future. Next we'll discuss about how to express timetabled events or scheduled events. What is the tense we use for this? The present simple tense. So the present simple tense is usually used to refer to future events that are scheduled. Look at the example sentences given. Hurry up. The train departs in 10 minutes. She has an appointment with the headmaster after school today. I leave Jaffna at 5 o'clock in the morning and arrive in Colombo at midnight the next day. Now all these three sentences talk about timetabled events which will happen in the future. But we can use simple present tense to express those future activities. Unlike future tenses, when you are talking about time-tabled events, you are using the present simple tense. So, you have to remember the grammatical structure when you are using present simple tense when you're talking about time-tabled events. The next future event is talking about intentions. An intention is a plan for the future that you have already thought about. What is the verb structure you use to talk about intentions? The auxiliary verb going to is used in talking about intentions. Let's look at the formula. The formula is am, o, is, o, are plus going to plus root form of the verb. Look at the examples. We are going to buy a new car next month. I am not going to watch TV until my science project is finished. He is going to get ready to see an exhibition. How do you talk about the arranged activities or arrangements? An arrangement is a plan for the future that you have already thought about and discussed with someone else. So you are going to use the present continuous tense to talk about arrangements. Look at the examples. I am meeting my mother at the airport tomorrow. My sister is visiting the dentist tomorrow evening. They are playing tennis with Team B after school today. So all these activities are arranged activities which will happen in the future. So you have to use present continuous tense to talk about arrangements. Go through activity 3 in unit 5 in page number 47 in your pupil's textbook. Discuss about 5 activities you have planned to do tomorrow. Use different structures of future form to talk about those activities. Now you can try to do the activity given. Put the verbs into the correct form. You may use different structures of future form to complete these future activities. So in this video lesson, you learned how to express future activities using different future tenses. Thank you for joining with Academic Mind. Enjoy learning with us. Have a good day.